But we've got to talk about the president's tantrum today. It is getting to be a regular thing. Presidential tantrums, tirades, but it's absolutely no coincidence that this one happened the day after Robert Mueller finally spoke out about his investigation. Did you catch this? The president slipped up this morning, tweeting this, "Russia, Russia, Russia. That's all you heard at the beginning of this witch hunt." Spoiler alert, it wasn't a witch hunt, but let's continue. "And now Russia has disappeared because I had nothing to do with Russia helping me get elected. Russia helping me get elected." Guess the president didn't mean to be quite so truthful there, because less than an hour later, he said this.
"No, Russia did not help me get elected. You know who got me elected? You know who got me elected? I got me elected. Russia didn't help me at all. Russia, if anything, I think, helped the other side."
Well, that's not what Vladimir Putin said.
"President Putin, did you want President Trump to win the election, and did you direct any of your officials to help him do that?"
"Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Because he talked about bringing the U.S.-Russia relationship back to normal."
Well, there you have it. Straight from the horse's, well, I mean the strong man's mouth. But that's not all. The president, back on his utterly false no obstruction, no collusion kick today.
"There's no obstruction. You see what we're saying? There's no obstruction, there's no collusion, there's no nothing. It's nothing but a witch hunt."
Well, that in spite of the fact that Mueller did not say there was no collusion. He said there wasn't enough evidence to charge anybody with conspiracy. He also didn't say there was no obstruction.
"If we had had confidence that the president clearly did not commit a crime, we would have said so."
So the president, of course, lashed out with personal attacks on Mueller.
"I think he's totally conflicted because, as you know, he wanted to be the FBI director and I said no. As you know, I had a business dispute with him after he left the FBI. We had a business dispute. Not a nice one. He wasn't happy with what I did. And I don't blame him, but I had to do it because that was the right thing to do."
None of that is true. None of it's true. The fact is, the Justice Department cleared Mueller of any conflicts. He did meet with Trump. But that was at the White House's invitation, and Mueller wasn't looking for the FBI job. But the thing the president really seems to be steamed about, that business dispute, which amounts to nothing more than Mueller quitting his membership at Trump's Virginia Golf Club and requesting a refund. That's it. Doesn't really seem like much of a conflict, does it? According to Mueller's report, Steve Bannon recalled telling the president that was ridiculous and not a real conflict. But the president had another personal attack to lob at Mueller today.
"He loves Comey. You look at the relationship that those two, so whether it's love or a deep like, but he was conflicted."
Okay, here's the fact on that one. The fact is, Comey told Congress that he admires Mueller as a colleague, but they're not friends. You know who told the president he is a friend of Mueller's?
"I told him how well I knew Bob Mueller and how, you know, the Barrs and Muellers were good friends and would be good friends when this is all over and so forth."
And speaking of the attorney general, he is not exactly taking his old friend's side in the dispute over Mueller, saying that he couldn't even consider charging the president with obstruction, specifically because of the DOJ regulations against charging a sitting president.
"He could have reached a conclusion. The opinion says you cannot indict a president while he's in office, but he could have reached a decision as to whether it was criminal activity. But he had his reasons for not doing it, which he explained. And I'm not going to, you know, argue about those reasons. But when he didn't make a decision, the Deputy Attorney General, Rod Rosenstein, and I felt it was necessary for us, as the heads of the department, to reach that decision."
Well, I mean, he seemed to suggest yesterday that there was another venue for this, and that was Congress.
Well, I'm not sure what he was suggesting, but, you know, the Department of Justice doesn't use our powers of investigating crimes as an adjunct to Congress.
So the attorney general says that he doesn't know what Mueller was suggesting. But it sure sounds like impeachment, the president's dreaded I word.
"To me, it's a dirty word, the word impeach. It's a dirty, filthy, disgusting word. And it had nothing to do with me."
A dirty, filthy, disgusting word. Well, words matter. And hat tip to our friend Anna Navarro, who tweets this. that this president boasted of grabbing women by the P word, calls some countries with mostly black and brown populations shitholes, referred to some African-American athletes as sons of bitches, says re-impeachment, the I word, is a dirty, filthy, disgusting word. And those words aren't my language. Those are direct quotes from the president. She is right. Irony is dead. But the president is not letting go of his grudge match with Robert Mueller and his team.
I think Mueller is a true never-Trumper. He's somebody that dislikes Donald Trump. Despite $40 million, 18 Trump haters, including people that work for Hillary Clinton and some of the worst human beings on earth, they got nothing.
Worst human beings on earth? Is he talking about these guys? Oh, no, those guys, those are the people this president makes excuses for. He praises. He sides with against his own intelligence agencies. Won't call on the carpet for murder. The president's fine with dictators and strongmen, but he unloads on U.S. law enforcement and counterintelligence officials. He's calling his fellow Americans, including lifelong Republican Robert Mueller, the worst human beings on earth, for doing their jobs and investigating Russia's election interference, an attack on our democracy. And what is the president doing tonight in the face of all this? The same old strategy, distract and deflect, with an announcement that he teased earlier as big league, he says. The announcement that he'll slap new tariffs on all goods imported from Mexico if the country doesn't stop the flow of migrants by June 10th. But the thing is, that's only going to end up forcing you to pay more for anything from Mexico that's sold in this country. That includes everything from beer to tomatoes, avocados, and berries, from phones to computers, from refrigerators to air conditioners, and cars like the Chevy Cruze and the Equinox and the Ford Fiesta and Fusion. Sounds like a tax to me. So it's just another distraction, just like his tirade this morning. We're almost used to the fact that this president seems to be willing to say or do anything to fend off his perceived enemies. But here's why his tirades and tantrums matter. Because the president is using his bully pulpit to lie, to deflect, and to distract, and to do it all out loud. That's why Robert Mueller needs to testify. He needs to state the facts out loud. The report is not enough. His 10-minute statement yesterday was not enough. He needs to speak the truth. And Congress, if they're devoted to transparency, if they really want answers, Congress should treat him exactly the way they would any other witnesses that they need to hear from. We all need to hear what he has to say. And like I said, the president had a complete meltdown today. So what was it about Robert Mueller's statement that sent him over the edge?